Wow, it is so nice.
Boyfriend, he actually got my drawing on a pillow.
So today is Thursday, March 26th. I actually did my makeup today, which is crazy because since I've been home, if you guys don't know, I live in the Bay Area. So our shelter in place, I think, began about a week ago. Honestly, like 2 or 3 days after that vlog happened from the last recent vlog that I posted. So ever since then, I've been pretty much home. I worked only that Monday, and then starting Tuesday I started working from home. Honestly, work is super busy. There's even been overtime, so I've been so busy, but I'm trying to like be productive at the same time with my own stuff. So yeah, I have a bunch of updates. Actually, I'm super excited to be vlogging. I know that I'm not going to be like traveling or like going anywhere, but since you guys liked my last vlog, I really wanted to vlog. I hope that this video is somehow positive and brings you some like light in, you know, in everything that's going on. I just wanted to introduce myself. I feel like I've never introduced myself in this vlog. So my name is Alex. I am going to be 24 years old in May, and I'm a recent grad. I graduated last year from UC Davis with a design major, and I'm currently working. That was kind of like my little intro. But yeah, I hope that you guys subscribe if you haven't already. It would make me super duper happy. I woke up pretty much at like around 8, and then I start work at 8:30. So I log into my computer, and we have meetings like at the beginning, midday, and end of the day. So right now it's our lunchtime, which I just clocked out for. And I'm about to eat some lunch, but I had breakfast earlier. I think it was like avocado toast and some tea, and yeah, that was pretty good. Since I've been staying home a lot, I decided to change up my room because I do not want a space where, like, since I'm gonna be here for probably a while, I just wanted to change it up and kind of make it look nicer and dedicate this time to like making my room look like a little bit more nicer. If you don't know, I share my room with my brother, so I don't have like my own room, but I'm still super grateful because I do have like a big enough space for actually my three main things, which is like my desk, my bed, and then my dresser, which is behind right there. So I can show you guys pretty much what I have for now, but few things are coming, like new pillows and stuff like that. So right here we have my bed, which I have had this for just the same for a while. This is literally like from college, but I have my lights here, which I've showed you guys in my last vlog, but I actually hung them up higher because they were too low, and like at the bottom of my bed you can see like the lights are all crumbled up like under there. So I just put it up higher and it looks so much better. And then I actually put this little board thing here for now. I want to change that, but I want to make use of that and not just get rid of it, so I'm just gonna have it there for now. I still have pretty much everything, and then my desk is actually here now, which that's our closet, but my desk is actually here now, and I don't have a lot going on because right now I'm like working from home, and then I have that computer, and then I have my actual like Mac, so it's like a bunch of things. I just want to leave it pretty plain. I write literally to-do lists like every single day, so this is where I started putting them on instead of putting them on my laptop. And then I just have that candle, which I love. It's like a lavender vanilla candle. Behind my mirror, which is now here, I have like my bags. I have my yoga mat, which I've been using a lot to work out, my little rug because I've been interchanging between both of these, so I just like keep those there. And then my tripod, lights and stuff like that, and then my purses as well, like right here, and all that stuff that's just trash. And then this one right here is already stuck to the wall here. I wanted to put it here, but I just left it there because it's gonna be a lot of work just taking it out from there. So I just put this little dog that I got a long time ago, and yeah, that's all I have right now. I really want to put a plant here, but I don't have any, and I can't really go out and buy anything like that because that's not an essential thing necessarily, so I'm just gonna wait for that. But I have that dog here, and then here these are clean clothes that I need to put away.
But this is kind of like the same setup I had on my dresser when it was on this side of my bed. But yeah, so this is pretty much just my rings, which I haven't worn in a while because I don't really go out. And then my brushes and then my palettes go here. And then I have this little ring, or not a ring holder, but like earring holder. And it looks like that. So I like it a lot. It keeps a lot of stuff. I've gotten rid of so many things, honestly. And then this is just my dresser, my little weights. I ordered some workout stuff since I'm gonna be working out from home, so I'm excited to like unpack that as well for you guys. And then I use this pillow, which has Fido's face on it. Fido is my dog, by the way. I think I've showed you guys him like a bunch of times. I think he's outside right now. But this pillow, Caesar, which is my boyfriend, he actually got my drawing on a pillow of Fido. So he gave me this like for Christmas one time, I think like last year, I don't remember. But he gave me this and then a purse or something. And then so this like is like the cutest thing and I love it. Like I've never had like any of my art on anything. So, and it's also like my dog, which I'm literally obsessed with my dog. So that's been on my chair as like a helping comfortable thing for just sitting here pretty much like all day because I'm literally working here all day. But that's what I have my room as for now. I'm literally dressed in like the comfiest thing ever, but I can show you I'm wearing this UC Davis sweater thing. These were actually my brother's, which I am wearing now because they don't fit him. So but that's the update. Hey guys, so I had lunch and then I've been just working on my computer. So since I'm on break now, I wanted to, this is like my last break. So my first break is at 10:30 in the morning and then I have lunch at like 12:45 and then my other break is at 3:30. So I wanted to show you guys something that I got today. So I've been wanting this for a while. I already took it out of the box because every time I've been getting a package now, I just like want to be smart about it and like cautious about it. So I usually use my gloves and like I'll like take out the box or whatever like in the front porch and then I'll get rid of that and then I'll keep the inside of the package. So what I wanted to unbox with you guys, pretty much I've been waiting to do this with you guys, is my new phone. I am so excited and super grateful that I can like purchase this for myself. Like so excited to like show you guys that pretty much everything that is in here. And right now I have the iPhone 8. Yeah, this is the iPhone 8 that I have right now. I just have a photo of Fido right here. Unfortunately I can't use this case, I don't think. I don't know, I'm gonna figure it out right now. But yeah, this is the case that I have and this is my phone. This is the iPhone 8. Before this, I had the 7. And before the 7, I had the 4S, which was the biggest change in my life. The 4S to the 7. So that's crazy. But yeah, I've had this for quite some time and I've wanted this phone for a while, I think. Honestly, yes, it's been a long time since I wanted this. So I haven't like driven my car in a while. Like I'm pretty sure like a lot of you might be in the same situation as me. Like I'm honestly saving like gas, but I haven't driven it like I think in like a week maybe. So it's just kind of been sitting here. I'm thinking of maybe like taking it out for a drive, like I don't know, like once every 2 weeks or something, just to make sure that like, you know, it keeps on running and stuff. But I got the iPhone 11 Pro. This is the one with the 3 cameras and I'm not too sure about the size, but we're gonna see it right now. I got the 64 gigabyte because the one that I have right now is a 64 gigabyte. And honestly, I don't think I need any more than that because in this phone, I have a lot of space left. I have like 19 gigabytes left, I believe. Okay, wait, too much. So I got this one in gold. As you can tell, this is the color with the 3 cameras. So I'm gonna open it. I haven't opened it at all. So I'm gonna just open this with you guys. And, ooh, okay. I gotta throw like everything away after. But it looks like this, looks super nice. I like the black color of the box. Wow, it is so nice. Okay, so
The thing with the case, I do not have a case. It is in the mail. Well, like, I have a case on the way for this. It is just transparent because I literally spent so much time trying to look and find for a case. But a lot of the Amazon orders are really backed up, so I just didn't want to order a case and then not get it until like April, the end of April pretty much, so like a month from now. So I decided to just find a simple like clear case somewhere else. So that is on the way, and also a clear what is this called, like the clear top, you know, clear screen thing. I wanted to find one as well, and I did order one. I ordered that one from Apple as well, so that'll be coming. But this is what it looks like right now, and it seems to have this little flappy thing, but I'm just gonna take it out. My hands are washed and clean, don't worry. But yeah, so it looks like it has that little screen as usual, as it does. I still need to set everything up, but I just want to show you guys pretty much. I'll show you, of course, like once it's all set up and everything's transferred and stuff. But then after the phone, we have this little, you know, little thing that comes with, I think, pretty much like most of the phones, where it just gives you like the little stickers and then just information and stuff. I like the whole design setup of this. Okay, and then we have the, is this the charger? I believe this is the little charger plug. And then there seems to be some headphones in here. So it's turning on. So what I want to do is pretty much like transfer everything from my iCloud from this one to this one first, and then actually like download all the apps and stuff like that as much as I can, so that it looks just like this. I'm planning to sell this phone because I do not have use for it. I want to make money out of it as well, because this was an expensive phone. So thankfully I got a good discount on this phone, but still, this is crazy that I just like oh my god, it looks so nice. I love just the design. There was an option to trade in this phone, but I figured that there is a better value if I just sell it on my own, and also that way I have time to like figure out the whole setup from this phone onto this one. So that is crazy. I just wanted to like show you guys. I'm going to be doing a what's on my iPhone 11 Pro on my main channel. If you want to check that out, I will definitely film that this weekend for sure, and I'm super excited about it because I haven't done a video like that in a while. I hope you guys are having a beautiful day or night. Thank you so much for being subscribed. It makes me super, super happy. Hey guys, so I am currently taking off my makeup. I am so tired. It is like 9:40. He's staring at me. Look at him. It is like 9:40 something, I believe, but I basically took Vito for a walk. I had dinner. I was supposed to work out my abs today because I did legs. No, I did booty and arms, but I didn't do that today because I am so sore. But I will try and aim to do abs tomorrow, and that should be exciting because I've been loving working out here. Because I haven't been sore in forever, because I was supposed to sign up to the gym and I didn't end up doing that because everything is closed now. So yes, so I plan to do abs tomorrow, but other than that, I completed everything on my wish list. Not my wish list, everything on my to-do list. But yeah, I actually am also back on TikTok. Don't judge me. But yes, so I made a TikTok, I think, I don't even know when, sometime this year, and I was posting like every single day because I was working from home. But ever since I got a job, I stopped making TikToks. So today I finally got back on it, and I will like probably add it on here. But I made a couple, I might add one, but yeah, I will have it linked down below if you guys want to follow me on TikTok. But I love that app because it's honestly pretty entertaining. Like, it's pretty funny, and I love like acting and like being funny and goofy. So honestly, it's whatever people like make judgments on, like whatever people think, I think it's a fun app. So Yes, so I'll have that link below, and I'm going to be getting ready for bed. And something that I've been doing every single night for the most part is I watch That's So Raven on my Mac with my brother before bed. So I'm just gonna wash my face and stuff like that and watch That's So Raven, and I will talk to you guys tomorrow. I hope you're having a beautiful day or night. Hey guys, so today is Sunday. I haven't vlogged the last few days because I'm going to tell you a story time of something that happened. It's not even funny, I don't know why I'm laughing, but I think I was nervous because you guys, it was really scary. I'm gonna tell you story time. It is it's the 29th, first of all. It is 1:57, so I have been up. As you can tell, I have like makeup on. But basically, I got up this morning and I had breakfast and I got ready, and I actually filmed another video yesterday. I also filmed a couple videos, so I just wanted to like film videos because I don't have any left, and I want to post this coming week and everything. So I filmed a lot of videos and I filmed a lot of TikToks also, don't judge me, but I have been getting back into TikTok. In is that a word? I don't even know. But yes, so I thought I would take you like behind the scenes of the things that I do. So pretty much I have this notebook. I write pretty much all my ideas on here about like what I want to film and what I'm gonna say. Like I kind of like just plan it out so that I'm not like just mindlessly just talking. So I have that, and then also I do this thing where I put my tripod here. I got this from Amazon. If you like want to film videos or anything, I highly recommend this. But I got this from Amazon and I put my camera here. I got this camera a while ago, as you guys know, and this is what I use on here on this tripod. And yes, so I pretty much have this and my camera here, which is this camera. And then I put my lights on and I actually sit on this pillow because I am too short. And this helps me like be at the same level as like this tripod when it's like filming me. And yeah, I actually turn on this light back here, which makes a huge difference, as you can tell. My dad put this up a while ago and I really like it. It really helps with the lighting since I don't have like an actual like full on like, you know, like studio light kind of thing. And I don't really feel like I should get one because I don't have space for it. So this is pretty much how I film my videos. Something that I got in the mail recently that I haven't showed you guys is this. I got my, what is this called? Like a mouse pad thing. This is from Amazon. I'm super happy with it. I love that it's circular. The one that I used to have was like a square shape thing, and I like this so much better. And my computer's not usually like turned this way just because I was like watching stuff while doing my makeup. But yeah, I really like this. I am happy with it. It was pretty affordable, so I have that already that came. My pillows haven't come yet, but I got my case and my screen protector from my phone. So I'm just using a clear case that I found from eBay, and I just added the Polaroid to make it just a little bit cuter and stuff. And then I have the screen protector from Apple, I believe. I kind of messed up here. It has a little bubble. What's on my iPhone will be up on my main channel if you want to check that out. But yeah, I just wanted to update you guys on like my screen protector and case and the stuff that I've been getting over here. Okay, that's better. The lighting is better. Okay, so pretty much on Friday, I was not feeling very well, and I remember I vlogged for you guys on Thursday, and right now it's Sunday, so I skipped a bunch of days. I know I was planning to vlog like pretty much this whole weekend, but that didn't work out, but that's okay. But yeah, so on Friday I was not feeling very well. I was working on my desk from home and it was like 3-ish or so, and I started to smell like bleach. And I know my mom uses bleach to clean the bathroom sometimes, and so I smelt it pretty strong, even though like the bathroom is like back there and like my room is here. But I smelt it pretty strong and like my window was closed. So like I told my mom, like, hey mom, like it smells like bleach. And she was like, oh, like yes, I'm using bleach to clean the bathroom, but I have all the windows open and everything. But like you should open your window like in your room as well. And I couldn't open it because I have it taped down because it gets cold in my room. So my dad came and like he opened it, and like there was a lot of air coming in, and I just kept working. And then all of a sudden I started to feel like not okay. Like I felt like my head has never been so heavy in my life. It was the craziest thing. Like I have felt my head feel heavy before, but never to this point. And I started to like feel like my eyes were burning and like not okay. And I thought it was, I started crying. Like I literally started crying, and I felt like I was being emotional. And I was like, I'm probably just being emotional. And so I went to the bathroom and I wiped my face and, you know, my tears and everything. And I just got out of the bathroom and I came back into my desk. And obviously, without thinking, I went into the bathroom when my mom had cleaned the entire bathroom with like, well, most of the bathroom with like bleach. And I didn't realize, and I just came back to my desk and I kept working, and I kept feeling even more like horrible. Like I felt like things were going blurry, like I was gonna pass out or something. And I called out my mom, and I think she realized my voice was like it was cracking, like I didn't sound okay. And so she came running to me, and like it was really scary because I have never felt like that in my life. And she was like, you're allergic to bleach. And I'm like, what? Like, what? How is one person allergic to bleach? But yeah, it was really scary. And like she's like, you're allergic, like we need to get you out of here and everything. And so they, my brother and my dad, my brother didn't even smell anything. He was not like fazed at all, like with the smell. And my mom either, because she had been the one that was cleaning and using it. So I literally was like in tears. I kept grabbing my head, like holding myself. And like it was the weirdest thing. They rolled me in my chair, they just rolled me out to the front porch, to the window, no sorry, to the door. Oh, I think it's raining. But yeah, so they like took me out there, and it was insane. Like I just kept feeling worse, like I did not feel okay. Like I started shivering, like I couldn't stop like shivering. Like, and my mom actually is a doctor. She has gone through the whole medical field stuff. She is very knowledgeable of all these kinds of things, actually. And so she was able to, it's raining really hard. So the first thing that she did was like, she looked for my inhaler, which I had one, but I had not remembered. I have the worst memory. I did not remember where I had put it, but she found my inhaler. She like gave it to me, and I started like using it. And I was trying to calm down. Like my brother kept telling me like, breathe, like, you know, like everything's gonna be okay. Like breathe, like all this stuff. Like he was like, breathe in, breathe out, like all this stuff. He was trying to walk me through it. And yeah, like, I feel like my dad didn't even know what to do. And like my mom was like freaking out at one point too, because she has been in that situation where an allergic reaction like that can end up pretty badly, to the point where I can't breathe. So my dad actually pointed out like, something is in your tongue. And I was like, my tongue? I couldn't obviously see my tongue. So my dad's like, I think your tongue is like getting swollen or something, or like it has dots or something, like grown like little white dots or something like that. And I was like, okay, that started to freak me out while I was trying to calm down. But obviously I had to know what was going on. And that's when I think my mom like really got like overwhelmed, like to the point where she felt really bad, like, because none of us knew that I was like this allergic. And she didn't know I had walked into the bathroom, and which was not smart of me. Like I had already smelt it from afar. I shouldn't have walked into the bathroom. But anyways, yeah, so she gave me some stuff to take for the pain and everything. And she was looking through other like things she might have that might help me. And she actually took my blood pressure, and it was incredibly high. I trust her judgment, and it was really high. She told me that I was having, she knows that, she would tell me the terms in Spanish, so I'm not sure like everything in English. And I'm not like anywhere near like medical expertise or anything at all, so I don't want to say like the wrong things, but I could not stop shaking and my blood pressure was super high. She wanted to take me to the hospital and I did not want to go to the hospital. I feel like this was a bad call for me to take, but luckily like everything was okay. But I just felt really anxious about going into the hospital when like there's so many cases with the virus at this moment. So yeah, luckily what she was giving me actually was helping me a lot, and they took me outside and I was sitting outside for a long time and I drank a lot of water where I had to pee so bad, and I couldn't go into the house because it still smelled like bleach. So it was super scary, but just overall I just want to give you guys that story time because I know that that was the scariest thing I have gone through in a long time. So I definitely just wanted to like open up and let you guys know how like that happened. But yes, I'm obviously feeling a lot better. I do not feel like, and like I was coughing then as well, like I was losing my earring, like my hearing on my left, like I started more pain on my left than on my right. It was so many things going on, but I definitely do feel a lot better. And yeah, I just wanted to give you and share with you guys that story time because it was honestly so scary. But thankfully everything turned out fine and I feel so much better now. But yes, I wanted to just let you guys know what was going on, and yeah, that was super scary. But for today, right now it's 2, so I'm just gonna, I filmed obviously like a few videos and stuff, so I'm just gonna be editing for the pretty much the rest of the day and stuff, so that'll definitely keep me busy as it always does. But yeah, definitely subscribe to my main channel if you haven't already, and I will talk to you guys very soon, and definitely stay safe, and I hope you're having a beautiful day or night, and I'll talk to you guys in my next vlog. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up because that kind of lets me know that I'm not like boring you guys with like vlogs with just me being at home. So I feel like this really like helps me like get to connect with you guys and let you guys in on like my life and like all that stuff. So I definitely do like vlogging from home, but I also don't want it to be boring. So I definitely wanted to just put that out there. So definitely give this video a thumbs up because it lets me know that you guys like these at home vlogs kind of things. And yeah, I will talk to you guys very soon in my next video, and I hope you're having a beautiful day or night. Bye guys.